So you've just taken your first photos for digital photography, and now you need to get the pictures off of your camera and onto your laptop so that you can edit them. The first step is to remove the SD card from your camera. On Nikons, the SD card is on the right side of the camera, inside a door that you pull back with your finger to open. On Canons, the SD card is located next to the battery on the bottom of the camera, inside a door that you open by pushing a tab and lifting open. Once the SD card is exposed, you can release it by pushing down on it. When you do, it should spring up. Then it can be removed. Note the small tab on the side of your SD card. This is the card lock. If the tab is ever in the lock position, you will not be able to record any pictures onto the card. So before we move on, make sure that the tab is in the unlocked position. Please be careful with these SD cards. They are delicate and easily breakable. Never force one of these cards into anything. By using a gentle touch, these cards should last you a long time. Once the card is out of the camera, find the SD card slot on your laptop. For most of you, it will be on the right-hand side of your MacBook Pro. If you have an older model like me, it may be on the left. Gently place the card into the slot until it stops. Most of you will immediately see a program pop up after you insert your SD card. It may be iPhoto or Dropbox or any number of programs. At the very least, you should see a new drive pop up on your desktop or in Finder with the make and model of your camera. Sometimes nothing happens when you insert your SD card into your computer. If that's happening to you, I wanted to let you know there is another way. You can connect your camera to your laptop using a USB cable. Start by putting your SD card back into the camera. The USB cable that you need is a fairly common one that you may already have around your home. It has a mini USB plug on one side that attaches to your camera here, and a standard USB plug on the other end that you can plug into your laptop. Once your camera is turned on, you should be able to access the photos on the SD card. Many of you are probably familiar with iPhoto. It's Apple's default photo organization application. In this class, however, we're not going to use iPhoto, ever. In fact, we're going to turn it off so that it doesn't bother us again. The reason for that is that iPhoto converts raw images directly into JPEGs and then buries the original raw files in a directory that's really hard to find on your computer. That's counterproductive for us. We need to easily find those raw files so that we can edit them in a part of Photoshop called Adobe Camera Raw. To avoid this situation in iPhoto, I'd like you to use a program called Image Capture to transfer your raw photos from your camera to your laptop. But before we do that, we need to disable iPhoto. Go to Finder and click on Applications. Then locate iPhoto and open it. Under the bold iPhoto menu on the left, choose Preferences. Then under the General tab, find the drop-down that says Connecting Camera Opens. Choose Image Capture from that list. Then you can quit out of iPhoto. It should not come up again when you insert an SD card. Next, we need to open Image Capture. Find Image Capture in the Applications folder and double-click the icon to open the program. Once inside, you should see thumbnails of all your photos. Notice the name and extension of your files. Each camera manufacturer has its own type of raw picture file. For Nikons, you should see .nef. For Canons, you should see .cr2. If the file extension is JPEG, it means you have your camera set incorrectly. You'll need to set your camera to shoot in RAW and then reshoot the assignment. If you are seeing RAW photos in Image Capture, then we can proceed. Go to the drop-down at the bottom of the page that says Import To. From the drop-down, choose Other. Next, browse to a location on your computer where you'd like to keep all of your photos for DPH. I've chosen my desktop, but you may have a special folder for all of your DPH files that you'd like to use. Then create a new directory by clicking on the button in the lower left labeled New Folder. Name it RAWs. Then click Choose on the bottom right. When you're done, the RAWs folder should be listed at the bottom of the drop-down next to Import To. This is the folder that your RAW files will be transferred to. Next, select the photos you would like to transfer. Hold down the Shift key between clicks to select a range of photos, or hold down the Command key to select images that are not next to one another. Once you've selected all of the photos you want to transfer, click the Import button. Notice that if you hit the Import All button, every file on the card will be transferred to your computer. If that's what you want, the button can be a time saver. Image Capture will notify you of the file transfer process and mark pictures that have already been transferred with a green check at the bottom right of each thumbnail. After you close Image Capture, go to the RAWs folder on your computer and double check that Image Capture transferred the files correctly. So that's it. Now you know the best way to transfer your RAW files from your camera to your laptop.